Okay, so good evening to everyone. So welcome to our nightly mentoring session, or we say mentoring training. So how is everyone doing? Okay, so I hope everything is working well with everyone. So I really encourage everyone to keep attending our mentoring training. And if you have time, you can always watch the replay of this, and you can also share this to all your prospective diamond builders or to the diamond builders under you, so they would be more encouraged, and they will be they will learn what to do, especially in this 1088 program. So tonight we are going to study about wealth transfer during hard times. So we know that we are still in the midst of the pandemic crisis, and we know that a lot of people have suffered difficulties. A lot of people had gone through a lot of hard times. So that's why it's very important that we understand that even though there's a lot of bad things happening, you got to understand there's always at the other side of the coin. And on the other side, we always need to realize that there are also good things that can happen in this in the midst of this crisis. In Ecclesiastes 9:11, it says, "I have observed something else under the sun. The fastest runner does not always win the race, and the strongest warrior does not always win the battle. The wise sometimes go hungry, and the skillful are not necessarily wealthy. And those who are educated don't always lead successful lives. It's all decided by chance, by being on the right place at the right time." That's why we always believe that in the middle of any crisis, there will always be opportunity. Every crisis will always be a door to your miraculous change. Every crisis can lead you to a breakthrough. You see, you got to understand that any situation that is happening to your life, God will always be there, and all things work together for good. So it's very important that we understand, even in the Bible, that wealth transfer always happens during crisis. So wealth transfer is all about stepping into God's timing. So God's timing is always perfect timing. The good thing is, the pattern is, miracles are always preceded by difficulties. Miracles are preceded by crisis. That's why we are always confident that whatever with this pandemic, this COVID-19 thing, can lead us to miracle. It can lead us to breakthrough. It can lead us to something that we had not been expecting. God can surprise us with a lot of things. You just need to hold on to your goals. You just need to hold. God's plan in your life will never be locked down. Amen. So we are in the middle of this phenomenon. It's a pattern that has occurred before, a pattern of difficult situation. So alam naman natin, although we were caught by surprise kasi ngayon lang naman talaga na lockdown ang buong mundo, pero hindi naman first time. Hindi naman first time na nagkaroon ng crisis. In fact, in 1924, nagkaroon na ng ganitong tinatawag na pandemic crisis, no? Yun nga lang, syempre, iba yung sitwasyon noon, iba yung sitwasyon ngayon. Although buti nga tayo, kahit naka-lockdown, we still have the internet, we still have the television, we still have access to the market. Pero before, yung mga tao na lockdown, they are locked. They are literally locked in their houses and they cannot move out. Okay? So the question is, what God had done before in difficult times? So we have to see the pattern. Hindi naman first time na nagkaroon ng crisis. Hindi naman first time na nadumaan tayo sa matinding problema. Ang tanong, in the past, have you experienced problem? Have you experienced difficulties? The question is, did God help you during those difficult times? In the Bible, we have seen a lot of situation Did God help those people during hard times? That's why this is a question of hope. What are we hoping for? So what are we looking forward? Na ito bang mga crisis na to, alam ba natin that God, do we really believe deep inside our heart that God will show up in our most difficult situation? That whatever challenges you are going through, you know that things can happen. Great things can happen in your life. Amen? So, Ecclesiastes 1, 9 to 10, here history merely repeats itself. It has all been done before. Nothing under the sun is truly new. Wala naman talagang bago. Ang medyo bago lang is hindi tayo nasanay na naka-lockdown lahat. Some people says, here is something new, but actually it is already old. Nothing is ever truly new. Like when you are setting goals, when you are want to achieve great things, hindi naman yan bago. For some of you, matagal na kayo nangangarap na magkaroon ng sasakyan. Matagal na kayo nangangarap na magkaroon ng bahay at lupa. Matagal na kayo nangangarap na kumita ng 6-figure a month or 7-figure a month. It's a question of, kailan siya mangyayari? Now, you see, the good thing right now is, the pattern is, usually, those things that you don't expect happens during hard times. Kaya dapat ang makita natin dito, what is the positive side of this pandemic crisis. Every wealth transfer in the Bible happened in difficult time. It's not a special miracle. It's a pattern. It's really a pattern that happened many times. So kung maintindihan natin ito, no, so at least it gives us so much hope that there's a lot of great things ahead of us. Dahil nakikita natin medyo patapos na to, no? Medyo patapos na itong pandemic na to. Hindi man tayo babalik dati sa normal, gaya ng dati, pero nakikita na natin, yesterday, dineclare na ang buong Pilipinas as a low risk in COVID. So pababa na talaga yung mga cases. And maraming mga lugar na hindi na sila nagre-require ng RT-PCR test or swab test. May mga bansa rin na hindi na nagre-require ng quarantine. So we are getting there. We are getting there. So as the country, the whole world is busy facing this crisis. But God has and His angel is busy transferring wealth into our hands. The question is, are you ready for that? Is your mindset geared towards that principle that God is busy transferring wealth into our hands? If you believe on that, then you know that whatever you want in life, whatever your goal is, it is going to happen. Amen? So turbulence is for a short period of time. God is on the move. So nakaranas na ba kayong sumakay sa airplane, tas may turbulence? O diba yung turbulence naman yun, magbagamat nakakatakot siya, pero alam mo, sandali lang siya. Hindi naman siguro kayo maka-experience ng turbulence na yung whole course ng flight. Halimbawa, isang oras ba siya, dalawang oras? No, usually, minutes lang siya, no? Pero grabe, yung minutes na yon sobrang scary, di ba? Ganon din naman itong pandemic, bagamat magdadalawang taon na siya, but this is just a turbulence. But we still believe that even in the midst of this turbulence, God is on the move. Our future is God's history. In 2 Kings 6:24 to 33 and 7:1 and 2, it says there, we now know what's going on. God is transferring wealth into our hands. The question is, are we ready? Make sure we are all prepared. We keep on planning. We keep strategizing. Because you know, sometimes the danger of a crisis is, when you are in the midst of crisis, sometimes you tend to become idle. Iniisip mo, ba't ako magpaplano? Ba't ako magre-ready? Ba't ako mag-strategize? Crisis nga, di ba? So parang, hindi ba useless yon na ako dito ngayon pa ako magpapaplano? You see, the person who are prepared, the person who keeps planning, the person who keeps strategizing, the moment this transfer, this crisis is over, they are the one who is bound to win. Did you hear that? Let me repeat that. In the midst of this crisis, the person who is prepared, the person who keeps on planning, the person who keeps on strategizing, when this crisis is over, they are the one who will benefit from it. Okay? And they are the one who will come out victorious. So just keep planning. Keep preparing. Keep strategizing. Even things are so blurred. Even things that probably you are saying that parang wala naman ako nakikitang liwanag, di ba? But as the saying always goes, there's always light at the end of every tunnel. Nakadaan na ba kayo dun sa isang tunnel na walang ilaw? O di ba parang walang katapusan, di ba? Parang iniisip mo, matatapos ba ito? Matatapos ba ito? Or nakasakay na ba kayo dun sa ano, sa mga roller coaster, di ba? If you've been to Singapore or Hong Kong sa mga Disneyland, di ba? Pag sumasakay kayo sa mga roller coaster na madidilim, yung sa mga loob, yung parang kala mo, katapusan mo na, di ba? But alam mo matatapos. Alam mo matatapos yan. Alam mo sa dulo, may liwanag. So that's why this is so important. We now know what's going on. Ano na yan? Given na yan eh. Given na itong pandemic. God is transferring wealth into our hands. So make sure you're all prepared, you keep planning, you keep strategizing. So we need to settle in and keep on building our daily routine. Let's pray a lot, let's plan a lot, let's continue to strategize and keep your mind sharp. Kaya nga alam nyo, pag ganitong crisis, ano, actually sa totoo lang, ngayon lang din kayo parang maraming oras na makinig ng mga ganitong klaseng training. Dahil before the pandemic, parang wala naman tayo masyadong ganitong oras, ano? Dahil busy tayo sa mga ginagawa natin. Pero ngayon, parang with the technology, ngayon naman dito na tayo lahat sa Zoom or sa Facebook Live, it seems that we have more time sharpening our mind. So you have to stay in control right now in the midst of this pandemic. How do you stay in control? Keep on counting all your blessing amidst the uncertainty. Because, you know, every thing is a blessing. Yun nga lang bumangon, yun lang magising ka sa umaga, di ba? Kaya nga sabi nila, every gising is a blessing. Okay? At least you're still alive. Whenever you I have visited Boracay, Palawan. So what else you have been visited right now? And probably not only the places in the Philippines, some of you have been to other countries. You have visited Singapore, Hong Kong, Thailand, Korea, Japan. Kaya nga, alam niyo, to stay in control, sometimes, instead na palagi kayo nagbabrowse ng kung ano sa Facebook, mag-post ka rin ng mga memories mo, no, of the past. That in the midst of this pandemic, alam mo, you have been into places, okay, in the past. So kaya, usually, di ba, sa Facebook naman, nagre-recall siya ng mga, ang tawag doon, parang past post mo, di ba, mga stories, nagre-repost siya. Halimbawa ngayon, October 26, tapos bigla may magpa-post sa Facebook na memories, October 26, 2017. So you keep on posting that because it's one way of thanking God that even in the midst of this pandemic, you know that once in your life, you were able to visit those places. Okay? And you have to stay focused in what you can do and not on what you cannot. Minsan kasi, di ba, parang ang lagi natin iniisip is, kaya ko ba to? Kaya ko ba yan? Di ba yung mga, alam nyo, kung ano yung kaya mo, yun ang i-focus mo. And how do you do it? Keep on establishing your routine. Focus on your business activity, not the lockdown. Keep yourself BC. Okay? Because the moment you keep yourself idle, mas lalo ka madidepress at mas lalo ang nakikita mo puro bad news. Lalo na ngayon, di ba? Pag binuksan mo ang Facebook, puro politics. Di ba? Puro awa yan. Kaya... hindi ka nagbabrowse ng Facebook. Keep educating people. Dito sa virus na to, naintindihan na natin na ang recovery rate is 95%. At ang kailangan lang naman talagang gawin ay strengthen ang immune system. Instead na matakot ka, instead na mag-worry ka na ayan na naman, baka maapektuhan na naman ako ng virus. And the more you worry, the more that you cannot accomplish your goal. Yung lahat ka na lang natatakot, paano kung ikaw ay ma-impact ng virus? Yung iba natatakot magbabakuna. Sasabihin nila yung mga epekto nito, di ba? Instead of focusing on what you can do. So you have to focus on what you can do and not on what you cannot do. Okay? Always stay positive. Focus on your daily goals. What are your daily goals? What do you want to accomplish for the day? What are your weekly goals? What do you want to accomplish for the week? What are your monthly goals? Okay, meron tayong tinatawag na you have to calendar everything that you do. Why? Because I have proven that anything that you don't calendar, you will never do it. Focus on your daily routine. Focus on how you can make work from home or focus on how you can make your day productive. Some of you have been listening here. Ay na-stuck na kayo dyan sa bahay, hindi kayo lumalabas kasi natatakot kayo. But even if you are at home, you can be productive. You can still work 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Monday to Saturday. You can help us in our wellness. You can help us here in 1088 program with all other projects and program of LSA. The most important thing is you are in control and you really understand what you want to accomplish in the next 90 days. You have to have control what you let in your mind. Yung pumapasok sa mind mo, no? Kasi lalo na yung mga social media. You need to block out the nonsense things that will not contribute to your productivity. Post only encouraging words, good news, solution to problems. Me personally, if you are going to visit my Facebook account, never in my life that I post personal problem. I have never anything. Any negative things on the Facebook. The only thing that I will post in Facebook is something that will encourage people, something that will bring solution to problem to people. But a lot of people, they've been using Facebook to really bring out what is in their heart. Remember, whatever you post on the Facebook is a reflection of who you are. So you need to minimize reading news. Listening to news or watching news, you have to stay on track on what you want to Okay, are you learning? So it's time to hit the reset button and get hold of your reality. Focus on what matters and get rid of what does not. You know, marami na nangyari, no? Since this lockdown, 3.7 billion in the whole world got locked down. The IMF declared, or the International Monetary Fund declared that global economic recession had reached almost $2 trillion. Here in the Philippines, the stock market dropped to 2011 level. It's a 4,200 to 5,200 index. People will be more health conscious. Nakikita naman natin ngayon, ano, parang dati naman, hindi naman nag-alcohol or whatsoever. Pero ngayon, di ba, parang sanay na mga tao. Pag nakakita ng alcohol, alcohol agad. Physical and social distancing is now becoming a norm of life. Wearing face masks is now becoming a norm of life. People start to realize the importance of savings and investment. But though you will see that they prioritize liquidity, kaya nga, pansinin nyo, pag crisis at may pera ka, this is the perfect timing to buy properties. Why? Because people wants to become liquid. So, ang mangyayari dyan, ibebenta nila yung mga properties nila sa mababang halaga. This also the time to for great business idea. The work from home or the online business. Like, kaya nga itong 1088 natin is a perfect business because you can do it online. At tandaan po natin, ano, itong ating 1088 ay na-conceptualize natin to sa gitna ng crisis. That's why we can always conclude, God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. So get ahead and do the things you wanted or even needed to do. Reprioritize your life. Today is the best day to prepare whether this lockdown or this community quarantine will end or not. You always pray for the best and prepare for the worst. Lots of people will lose their job, but we can provide them opportunities to make money. Kaya nga, it's how you see things. When people see things on a negative way, then you can inject to them positive perspective. Nawalan sila ng trabaho, bigyan mo sila ng opportunity kumita. People will prioritize spending their money on essentials and necessities like food, medicine, hygiene product. That's why we are so blessed kasi mga produkto natin are essentials. Kaya nga, pansinin ninyo, ano mga naapektuhang negosyo? Lahat ng luxurious naapektuhan yan. Dahil sino pa ba naman ang bibili ng mga luxury car, luxury jewelries, ano pa mga naapektuhan? Yung mga RTW, di ba? Kaya ang dami nagsara ng mga H&M, ang dami nagsara ng mga store, and yung some of them, pumunta na lang sila sa mga online. Okay? When emotions run high, intelligence runs low. And we cannot really avoid these things. Because sabi nga, hindi naman nire-report eh. Mas marami pang namamatay sa depression kaysa dito sa COVID-19. Okay? Isipin mo yung mga iba na lockdown. Na lockdown sila. Alam niyo ba na meron kami mga kakilala na magmula na nag-lockdown noong March 2020 until now, so it's been a 1.5 years, ay hindi pa talaga sila nakakalabas ng bahay ever. Imagine that, di ba? Kaya mo ba yun? Di ba? Parang hindi naman natin lahat kakayanin yun. So let's face the fact that this crisis is really difficult. But this is also the best time to sharpen our minds, keep reading books, keep listening to motivational speaker, and keep improving yourself as a person. Instinct serve you better than emotions will. It's your ability to adapt in any situation that comes your way determines your future. So we have to learn how to adapt to the new normal. Always focus on the solution. Okay? Lagi ang, kung meron tayo, every day we will encounter problems. But it's not about the problems. It's about the solution. Your ability to cope up with your environment. How are you going to work on it? Times like this will pass. Do you believe on that? The Bible says that everything will end in praise. We just need to set our mind to what I call the post-lockdown. We need to be prepared. What if this lockdown will end by December? Are you ready to face 2022? Or baka naman sa 2020? Kasi may mga iba, sasabihin nila, sige, pag okay na, saka na ako magre-ready. No. During this course of lockdown, this is a preparation time. This is the time to become, to get ready. We need to be prepared. Start anew. Don't carry yesterday's baggage in today. Okay? What, every single day, even in the midst of this pandemic, every single day, it should be a new beginning, a fresh start, looking forward to something great. If that is your mindset, and you will all have the reason to get excited about the future. Are you learning? That's why we need to start changing and adapting to the new normal of our society. Otherwise, if we don't innovate, we will evaporate. Okay? So I hope that you learn from this mentoring session or mentoring training. If you have, kung meron kayong, you feel that you have something to share, I really encourage you to type it in the comment section. If you learn something, if there's something that you want to encourage other people or watching right now, please don't hesitate to write down your comment below. And let's encourage one another, because I believe with all of my heart, very, very soon, this pandemic things will end. That's why we have to be very, very ready. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you. And I hope that we hope and pray for everyone that whatever your plans, whatever goals that God has placed in your heart, and you can look forward that it's about to happen. God bless everyone. See you at the top.